Jurassic Park is a franchise filled with little questions we may never get the true answer to, but today we're going to attempt to definitively answer at least one of them. Was the Dilophosaurus in the first Jurassic Park a juvenile or an adult? So let's take a look at the reasoning behind both arguments. There's two main areas of discussion. The first is the references to the dinosaur size within the canon, and the second is a line that Dennis Nedry says in his scene with the Dilophosaurus. That line, "Thought you were one of your big brothers? You're not so bad," he says just before he gets eaten, is basically what started this whole thing off. For some people, he means the juvenile Dilophosaurus he's facing up against isn't as frightening as the larger Dilophosaurs in the rest of the park, and for some other people, myself included, I will admit, he's referring to the larger, scary dinosaurs like the Tyrannosaurus Rex, and in particular, probably the Velociraptors. I do think I've got some decent evidence for my argument that'll come up a bit later in this video, but until I started scripting and researching this, my main reasoning was simply that Dennis Nedry is likely unfamiliar with the dinosaurs of Jurassic Park. He's clearly unaware of the attacking abilities of the Dilophosaurus given his ignorance at its impending death. If he knew the Dilophosaurus could spit and tear him apart, I doubt he'd have reacted the same way. We're going to cover this a little bit more later anyway. The main issue is with the size of the dinosaur itself, and this is something that changes multiple times throughout the Jurassic Park franchise. The Dilophosaurus in the film comes up to about 2/3 the height of Dennis Nedry, i.e. actor Wayne Knight, though it does appear smaller in some scenes as it crouches down and is lowered into the trench that was required to operate its puppet correctly. I couldn't find a reference to the height of Dennis Nedry anywhere in the novels or the films, so let's assume for now that he's the same height as the actor who stands at just under 5'6", please no manlet jokes, or 1.7 meters if you're that way inclined. This would put the Jurassic Park Dilophosaurus at 1.13 meters, or about 3'7". There's also a scene with a taxidermy Dilophosaurus in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, which Claire stands beside, and yes, these are confirmed to be taxidermy dinosaurs rather than statues. Claire's actress, Bryce Dallas Howard, is actually the same height as Wayne Knight, at just under 5'6", and the Dilophosaurus is again at approximately the same height relative to her body. It is slightly taller, but certainly no more than the 5 or so inches that it would take it above the 4-foot marker. I'm happy using that 4-foot going forward, as also the Jurassic Park trading cards released at the same time as the first film give the Dilophosaurus a size of 4 feet high, though one of them does mistakenly label it as 40 feet rather than 4 feet. Imagine the thrill on that thing. Light breeze would just send it flying. Anyway, this Dilophosaurus is of course significantly smaller than both its real-life non-Jurassic Parkified, hoping that catches on, counterpart, which is one of the earliest large carnivorous dinosaurs, could reach lengths of over 20 feet, and the novel variant of the dinosaur, which was stated to be 10 feet tall. According to the Making of Jurassic Park behind-the-scenes book, the Dilophosaurus was shrunk down significantly so that it didn't outshine the Velociraptors, which, along with the Rex, were clearly meant to be the stars of the show. It's also significantly smaller than its Jurassic Park the Game variant, and this is where things get a little bit trickier. Now, whilst the telltale version of the dinosaur is indeed about 4 foot tall, it's also directly referred to in bonus materials as a juvenile, and they even show what the full size of the dinosaur is meant to look like. At 20 foot long, it would match its real world counterpart, and frankly, look utterly bizarre. I don't want to get into a big discussion on how canon the Telltale game is, but just hold on to this info for a moment as we move on to the Lost World Jurassic Park, because in the Lost World Jurassic Park, the RV trailer towards the start of the film is shown flashing a number of Jurassic Park images, one of which shows the Dilophosaurus along with measurements and a text box. That text box says that the Dilophosaurus is 20 feet long. Phew, right. So far across the canon we have three different sizes of Dilophosaurus, but we're going to keep focusing on the films in particular. Whilst the 20 feet long reference in The Lost World is more evidence that the Nedry Dilophosaurus is a juvenile, I don't personally find it that compelling. This was an image briefly, oh so briefly shown, and barely noticed for years, and I suspect not a lot of research went into the image by the art department, who likely got the closest measurement for a Dilophosaurus they could, which for the real version is around 20 feet long. Now that's my opinion, but if we go back to Jurassic Park and the Dilophosaurus paddock, we can see that it's, well, it's not a particularly impressive fence, barely outscaling the tour jeep that drives past. There was only one Dilophosaurus paddock in Jurassic Park, so this is where they would all be held. And if the Dilophosaurus could indeed grow to 20 feet long, as the Telltale game and that image from The Lost World suggest, then even an electrified fence like this would likely prove to barely be a deterrent. Of course, perhaps Dr. Wu and the like weren't aware at the time that the Dilo would grow so large, but then Nedry of course wouldn't know that the other one he saw earlier was a juvenile, and I find it hard to believe they'd be so short-sighted, regardless, given the scale they have for the Tyrannosaurus paddock. The smoking gun for this entire argument and discussion is perhaps then going to be found in Jurassic World. I'm sure you've been waiting for me to get to this scene in particular, and the hologram of the Dilophosaurus that Delta squares up to in the film. Now, whilst this Dilophosaurus could have been scaled up or down, it is a hologram. The Apatosaurus hologram from the beginning of the film is realistic to its adult film counterpart, so I think it's safe to assume the Dilophosaurus hologram is the same. The question is then, how big is Delta? Again, I can't find official measurements on this. The Jurassic Wallard wiki, and yes, I mean Wallard, W-O-L-R-D, yeah, suggests that she's 5'6", but is she? Most sizing charts put the velociraptors in the franchise at anywhere from 5'5" to about 6', but for the sake of accuracy, we're going to compare her to a known quantity. Let's take a look at the shot from the film which shows Delta and the other raptors approaching Owen Grady. Delta is the one on the left, but all of them are approximately the same size anyway. Now, Chris Pratt stands at 1.88 meters, or just under 6'2". Same height as me, by the way, we're basically the same person. So, again, since we have no official measurements for Owen and we did it for the others, let's for now say Owen Grady is the same height, 6'2". I think that's a fairly good number for that kind of character. Given he's bent his legs slightly in this position, we can add an inch or two on top to get our full height. Now, and I know this is hardly serious maths right here, if we bring Delta forward so she's in line with Owen and then scale her up appropriately, we can get an approximate height for her. She'd come up to around Owen's neck, were he standing entirely straight, which definitely lines up with how the raptors are scaled in the rest of the film. We can extrapolate a more accurate height by finding the number of pixels to an inch. If Owen is 74 inches tall, just under 6'2" as he is in reality, then that's 905 pixels divided by 74 inches, giving us 12.2 pixels per inch. We now divide Delta's height in pixels, 807, by that same number, 12.2, to give us her height in inches, which is 66, which gives Delta a total height of 5'5", give or take an inch or two. This is the rough height for most of the velociraptors in the entire Jurassic Park franchise. They're intimidating big creatures, but they're usually not quite as tall as the humans, so I'm pretty safe and confident in saying 5'5" is a good number for Delta. So, we're in the endgame now, folks. Delta is 5'5". Let's go back to that hologram scene. On first glance, Delta and the Dilophosaurus appear to be the same height, but it's important to note the posture of the velociraptor in these scenes. Whilst her head isn't pointed forward, her body is certainly lowered much more than it is in that scene with Owen earlier, hunched down as the raptors do when they're preparing to attack. When she raises her body upwards, as she does when she first approaches the Dilophosaurus, as seen in this shot here, we can see that she is significantly taller than the hologram. If we take a look at another shot, the one in the scene that most closely resembles her appearance earlier in the film, in my opinion, then again we can see she's at least a full head above the hologram, likely at least half a foot or so, if not a little bit more. I won't pretend for a moment that this is the most accurate thing in the world. There is a degree of opinion in play here, but without official measurements, this is what we have to work from. So, given that the Dilophosaurus here is likely no taller than, say, 5', and that's being optimistic, and the one we see in every other iteration is only 20% smaller at about 4', I'm pretty confident in saying the Dilophosaurus from Jurassic Park is, in fact, not a juvenile. Nedry's comment about the Big Brothers being a larger Dilophosaurus makes even less sense post-analysis. Would he really notice the difference between a 4- and 5-foot Dilophosaurus? And if he did, would that difference be enough for him to let his guard down as entirely as he does? I'd suggest that even if you take the Dilophosaurus to be closer to 6', he'd be unlikely to make such a comment, and it'd only be logical if the Dilophosaurus could indeed grow to those astronomical 20-foot lengths, which, well, the evidence just isn't there. Even if you discount the hologram and say it's yet another juvenile Dilophosaurus in the hologram, well, why is the fence so weak? Why is a bigger deal not made about these gigantic dinosaurs? There's a lot of stuff in Jurassic Park the game that doesn't quite line up with film canon. It's certainly not to be taken as gospel, and I think this might be one of them. Furthermore, on a closing note, some size discrepancy is to be expected in fully grown creatures. Take humans, for example. Owen Grady is a full 8 inches taller than Wayne Knight, despite both being fully grown members of the same species and same gender, and that's hardly the biggest discrepancy you can find in humans or indeed other animals. I think the most you can say about the Dilophosaurus in Jurassic Park is that it's a young adult, but the evidence for it being a juvenile just isn't there in reality, and most of the fiction, Jurassic Park Operation Genesis, for example, portrayed the Dilophosaurus to be the same approximate size when fully grown, which is about 4 to 5 foot. So, there we go. Needlessly long analysis that will hopefully put to bed this question. I'm sure it won't. And I am also sure, despite this, some people will have counter-arguments and I'd love to hear them. Do let me know down below in the comments if you don't agree, if you believe otherwise, but most importantly, why? Give me some evidence. Let's discuss. If you enjoyed this video, it'd really help me out if you hit the like button. It took quite a little bit of work, this one, and whilst it may have seemed overkill to some of you at home, I've really enjoyed diving deep into such a pointless topic. Thanks for joining me as always, folks. Cheers, much love, bye bye. Quick little shout out at the end, this video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.